Good evening, everyone. Few students, they were in the graded classes the previous two sessions. And this is the third session, as Sadish sir told. I want to share with you a story before starting the session. You can read the last lines. I can do things you cannot. You can do things I cannot. Together we can do great things. Okay, that is what Sadish sir just now, he told, your feedback will give a more energy to us to for the next level. Okay, so what is the statement here? I can do things you cannot. You can do things I cannot. Together we can do great things. I'm going to share with you my experience. Thomas was my student and he was an autistic student. You all know what is autism, and you must have seen in your class some autistic students. Thomas is above 90% level autistic. But I learned many things from Thomas. He can't learn the things by listening. When I explain something, he can't, and he will not understand, or he can't learn. That we came to know from his parents and educational counselors. So what we teachers did, we wrote everything what we are teaching in simple way, like the slides, write everything on the board. So he reads, then he writes, then he learned. And finally, he scored 96% mark in his board examination. This is a real story. So even to learn a song, a film song or whatever it is by heart, he himself makes some videos and he will write the lyrics on the video. Then he will watch and he will learn the song. This is the way he is learning. So there are people who is not autistic also, they can learn only in this way. So this is an experience to any teacher. It's knowing that the child is learning not by hearing or listening the explanations. Okay, some people, they can't. This is a new thing I learned from Thomas. The same way teachers are learning many things from students. So we together grow, like in the previous slides, as I told, we think our brain will grow. We will give more work to our brain. Okay. Now, I'm going to start. I hope everyone remember what we have learned last session. Can you read this question? I hope everyone can see this question. Okay. A locker in bank has 3-digit lock. Mahesh forgot his password and was trying all possible combinations. 6 seconds for, he took 6 seconds for each try. The problem was that each digit can be from 0 to 9. How much time will be needed for Mahesh? This is the question. Okay. You can calculate and write your answer in the chat. Or yes, Rishikesh. Yes. Everyone can write the answer. Okay, everyone. Okay, Anvesha.
Yes, ma'am.
You are in which class?
Ma'am, I'm 10th now.
10th now. Okay. Anvesha, can you explain?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, I used the method you taught yesterday.
Yes.
The maximum number which can be on the lock is 999 if all three are 9. And okay. The first number is 0. So okay. If we take the total number of numbers, possible combinations is 1000.
Okay.
And 6 seconds for each try. So for 1000 seconds, the maximum time he can take, given that in the middle he does not find the combination, is 6000 seconds, which gives 100 minutes.
Okay. Okay. Rishikesh. Your answer is correct, Anvesha. Rishikesh. Rishikesh, can you unmute?
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. How did you get 3024?
I did 9 into 8 into 7. Into 6.
9 into 8 into. Okay. So here, this is a number lock, right? Yes. So you understood your mistake. You wrote the correct answer.
Yes.
Your answer is correct, Rishikesh. Now you corrected it to 6000 seconds or 100 minutes. Okay. Any doubt? Anyone?
No.
This is just to, if your answer is wrong or right, doesn't matter. We are just thinking, giving an exercise to your brain. Okay. Now you can see the next one. Numbers greater than 1000, but not greater than 4000 are to be formed with the digits 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Allowing repetitions, the number of possible numbers is. Yes, Sridhar, who is that? Any doubt? Someone raised the hand. If you have any doubt, you can unmute your mic and ask. Otherwise, you can write the answer. Take your notebook, your pen or pencil, and write the answer. Yes. Yes, children, did you understand here the question? The numbers are greater than 1000. Numbers are greater than 1000 and not greater than 4000. So first you have to think about it is how many digit number? How many digit number? Okay, how many digit number greater than 1000 and it is not greater than 4000. So you can think that these numbers they are four digit numbers. Yes, Sujal, you can unmute and tell, or you can write in the chat. Write in the chat so that also I can see. Okay. Yes, Sujay, it is four digit number. Okay. Now you, Sujal, you want to say something? You can unmute your mic and say. Okay, Devika. Devika, can you explain? We need a four digit number. Then how we will make the numbers? Tell me. All are silent. greater than 1000.
So, ma'am, can I?
Yes.
Okay. So, it'll be a four-digit number from 1001 to 4000.
Okay.
And like that, there are 3000 numbers.
And allowing repetitions.
Yes. So there are 3000 numbers, and then you can. Okay. Anyway, how I did it is the first digit has three possibilities. Then
who is speaking now? Who is speaking?
Abel.
Abel. Okay. Why are you counting all the numbers from 1000 to 4000?
No, I didn't do that. I just, no, the method I used was, I checked for the first digit. There are three possibilities.
Okay.
The second digit, there are five, third digit five, fourth digit five.
Okay.
So I multiplied all that and I got 375.
Hmm.
But then you can use the number 4000 also. So I added one to get 376.
Hmm.
And you cannot use 1000, so I subtracted one and I got 370.
Okay. So. Yes. Now, your answer is correct and your explanation is also very, very good. Okay, Abel, explanation is also good.
Thank you.
Okay, Sanath Salil, which class you are? Sanath? Okay. 1000, it should be greater than 1000. Greater than 1000. 1000. So here we can use 1. The first place we can use 1, 2, 3. 3 digits we can use. 3 digits. Okay. Because we can use 1, the number starting with 1, starting with 2, starting with 3. Okay. And here, since repetition allowed, we can use all the digits here. Here also, we can use all the digits. Here also, we can use all the digits. So this gives you 375. Now, not greater than 4000 means we can include 4000. So that will be 375 plus 1. But when we found 375, we included 1000 also, because we have taken 1 also in the first extreme left. So we have to remove that 1000. So the total is 375. Ananya, you don't need to take 4, because if you take 4, all the numbers more than 4000 will be also included. Because we need not greater than 4000 means we need only 4000. From 4001 onwards, we are not going to include. Is it clear? Okay. Anyone else have any doubt? Understood. Okay. Now we will move on to the next one. You can see here, there are 6 digits. How many 6 digits can be formed using the given digits? How many 6? Now you can write the answer in the chat. It's the continuation of the previous session. How many 6 digit numbers can be formed using the given digits? Right in the chat.
Ma'am, is repetition allowed?
Read this one. Given digits. Using the given digits. What is the meaning of that? Who is this? Someone asked, who is that?
Ma'am, Gaurinandan.
Gaurinandan, yesterday when we have done, no, do you remember given digits?
Yes, is that repetition?
Formed using the given digits means what? You have to use 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But it is not mentioned all the given digits. But it should be 6 digit numbers. What it is? Repetition allowed or not? Tell me, Gaurinandan.
repetition is allowed?
Look at this one. I'm just writing like this. Is this number included in this category?
Oh, okay, ma'am. Okay, ma'am.
Understood? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, Inish, correct. Yes, I can see here only three answers. You don't need to write the full multiplication, children. No need to take time to multiply. Just write the that method only. That is enough.
Ma'am, I got the method quickly, but then the multiplying.
What is that? What is that? Who is this Sujal? Sujal is raising hand, but he is not. Can you write, Sujal? Can you write? Yes, Alina. Alina. Alina, Muhammad, Atif, Rishikesh. Yes, Chris. Everyone's answer. Here it is 6 raised to 6. It is correct answer. 6 raised to 6 is 46,656. That is, so here we can keep all the 6. Okay, given digits means we can use repetition allowed. Okay, this is repetition allowed. Now look at the next question. Look at that wordings, the changes in the wordings. The first one was given digits. Here you have to use all the given digits. Okay. All the given digits. Yes. Now the answer is coming. Yes. Yes, Josh. Josh, can you explain? Josh, can you explain? Josh? Okay. Okay, children, your answers I have, I can see here. All the answers here, it is correct. Yes, who is that?
Ma'am, Pranjal.
Okay, Pranjal, explain.
Ma'am, over here, all the digits, all the given digits means repetition not allowed. So 6 very into good. 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, which is 720.
Yes, correct answer. 6 into 5 into 4 into, here in this place 3, here into 2, then here 1. So it is 6 into 5. So your answer is correct. It is 720. Okay. This way, if you write a number, look at this one. We have 6 digits. And if we have taken all the 6 digits and repetition not allowed. So it is coming 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay. This way of writing, I'm going to introduce a new term here. This is known as 6 factorial. 6 factorial. Okay. Next slide, you can see the next question. Look at this. There are 8 digits. There are 8 digits. How many different 8 digit numbers can you form without repetition? First question is without repetition. Without repetition, how many numbers you can form? How many numbers? Now you can use that. Yes, Deviga, Abel, Nikita. Yes, the word factorial. The word factorial, the notation is our exclamation mark. Exclamation mark. Okay. Yes, Kusum, Anvesha. First question is without repetition. Yes, your answer is correct. Without repetition, the answer will be 8 factorial. If it is with a repetition, no need to calculate. You just write what is the answer with the repetition. With the repetition, 8 to the power 8. Correct. So we got both the answers here. Here the answer will be 8 factorial. This answer will be 8 raised to 8. Okay. So this is factorial notation. Now you have just noticed these numbers. There are 8 numbers and you have taken all 8 at a time. And repetition not allowed. Now you can answer the next question. Write the answer. Now everyone can write the answer for the first part without repetition. Without repetition, what is the answer? You can use that. Yes, it is correct answer. It is 7 factorial. It is 7 factorial. And if it is with the repetition, with the repetition, 7 to the power 7. Okay, now can we form a formula? Can we form a formula from this? If there are n objects, there are n objects, it can be n colors, it can be n days, it can be n continents, it can be n any articles. Taken 8 at a time, how many different ways you can arrange if repetition not allowed? If repetition not allowed, it is n factorial. Correct. It is n factorial. If repetition, with repetition n to the power n. This is what you are going to learn in your school. Factorial notation. You can see here, number of objects, if it is 1, it will be 1 factorial. 2, 2 factorial, 3 factorial, 4 factorial, it goes like this. And these arrangements are known as permutations. Okay, these arrangements are known as permutation. This is in your textbook, you will learn in later, you will learn. Okay, now we are moving on to the next slide. Look at this one. How many different 5-digit numbers, how many different 5-digit numbers can you form without repetition? So it is, check the difference from the previous questions. Previous question, there were 8 digits. And we have taken all 8 at a time. All 8 at a time. Okay. Here there are 8 digits. But we are taking only 5 digits. So what will be the answer? 8 digits are there. But we need only 5 digits. So how we will write? Can we write 8 factorial, Gauri Nandan? How I will keep 8 factorial? Here I can keep all 8. Here I can keep 7. Here I can keep 6. Here 5. Here 4. How can I write 8 factorial? 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4. Correct. That is correct.
Ma'am, so we will do it like 8 factorial divided by 8 minus 5 factorial.
Okay, is this able?
Yes.
Okay, correct answer. Now, look at this one. Here it is not 8 factorial. We need 3 into 2 into 1 also. Then only it will be 8 factorial. So, it is 8 factorial divided by 3 into 2 into 1. Now, look at the next question. See the next question. There are 8 numbers, 8 digits. How many different 6 digits numbers you can form? How many 6-digit numbers. How many 6-digit numbers? You don't need to calculate, children. Yes, we can keep here 8 digits, here 7, here 6, here 5, then 4, then 3. So what is not there? What is not there? Yes, Inish, what is your doubt? Inish, what is your doubt? Can you unmute and ask? Why 3 into 2 into 1? Inish.
And then we are dividing.
Inish, what is 8? Here we have taken 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4. Correct, no? If I write 8 factorial, if I write 8 factorial, what we have to do here? We need a 3 into 2 into 1 also. Correct, no?
Yes.
8 factorial means 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Did you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
So I will write here 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4, then 3, then 2, then 1. But in our answer, it is up to 4 only. So I have to divide by 3 to 1, no? I have to divide by 3 into 2 into 1. Did you understand?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, that is why I divided by 3 into 2 into 1. So in that way, what is the answer for the next one? What is the answer for the next question? 8 factorial, yes. Alina Maria, your answer is correct. Divided by 2 into 1. Divided by 2 into 1. So this will be 8 factorial divided by 2 into 1. Now look at the next question. What will be the answer? Here there are 8 digits, but we are taking only 4. And repetition not allowed. Yes, Anvesha, your answer is correct. What is the answer? With the help of factorial, you write the answer. All of you write the answer with the help of factorial notation. We are taking correct answer. Yes. Okay. So you are saying that it is 8 factorial divided by 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Correct. What is that 4 into 3 into 2 into 1? Anyone?
It's 8 minus 4 factorial.
Why can't I say that it is 4 factorial, Abel?
Because it won't work for other numbers. Like for 5, you're going
to... No. For this question.
First thing, you can say it because 4 is the exact half of 8. So 8 minus 4 is the same as 4.
Okay. 4, instead of writing 1 into 2 into 3 into 4, I can write by 8 factorial. But in the previous one, 8 factorial by 2, I can't write. It is by, look at this one. Okay, look at this one. Here it is 8 by 2 factorial. This is 8 by, we are taking 5. So divided by 3 factorial. It is not 5 factorial. It is 3 factorial. Did you all understand? Now, can we form a formula from this? Anyone else? Anyone else? Gayatri. Gayatri, can we make a formula from this? Now we wrote all the answers with the help of the factorial notation. Gayatri?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So how we will write? There are 8 digits. We have taken 5 at a time without repetition.
Tell a formula.
Who is that?
Abel.
Abel, you already wrote answer, no? Yes, I'm giving chance to other students also, okay?
Yeah.
Okay, after that I will give you chance. Okay, Gayatri, tell me.
Ma'am, if we take like instead of 8 in these questions, we take it as n, then it'll be 10 factorial divided by n minus the
number. Okay, you tell in this particular case. In this particular case, it is 8 factorial by
h minus 5.
Yeah, correct. 8 factorial by 8 minus 5.
3 factorial.
Yes. So it will be 3 factorial. Then what will be the next one? Yes, Kusum. Kusum, how we will write the next one? Here we have 8 digits and we have taken 6 at a time. We have taken 6 at a time. Okay. And our answer is 8 factorial by 2 factorial. Rishikesh. Rishikesh, how we will write? Why can't we do 8 into 7 into 5? Then the answer will be 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. No, Rishikesh? Rishikesh?
Yes, sir.
If you divide by 8 into 7 into 6 into 5, then your answer will be wrong, no? You will get the answer 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. But our answer is not 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. We need 8. We need 7. Okay.
Yes.
Is it clear?
Yes.
Yes? Okay. Now, so 8 factorial by 2 factorial we can write. 8 factorial divided by 8 minus 6 factorial. 2 we can write 8 minus 6 because we are taking 6 digit numbers. 6 digit numbers. Okay. So what will be the answer for the last one? 8 factorial. Okay, Abel, tell me. 8 factorial divided by
8 minus 4 factorial.
8 minus 4 factorial. Correct.
Which is
8 minus 4 factorial. Now, now you can see the next. This is the permutation formula. What you have created the previous slide, 8 factorial divided by 8 minus 5 factorial, because you have taken 3 digits at a time. Second answer, 8 factorial divided by 8 minus 6 factorial, because you have taken 6 digits at a time. Then the next one was 8 factorial divided by 8 minus 4 factorial. That is, in that question, we have taken 4 digits at a time. So we can generalize the result. If there are n digits, yes. Anyone can generalize the result? Kusum, Gayatri, anyone? Or Nikita? Nikita?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, how we will generalize this result?
Ma'am, I didn't get you.
Yeah. From this, the previous question, it was 8 digits. And our question, you were not there, I think. You just now you joined?
No, I joined. I was there.
Okay. See, we made 8 from 8 digits. We have taken 5 at a time. Okay. Second question, 8 digits. We have taken 6 at a time. Third question, from 8 digits. We have taken 4 at a time. So if there are n digits, and we are taking r digits at a time. Okay, we say npr, the arrangements, n objects taken r at a time. Then we say npr. Permutation means arrangements. What we are doing, these all questions, we were doing the arrangements. We were arranging. Okay, so permutation means arrangement. So in mathematics, we use, instead of arrangements, we use the word permutation. Okay. Now, how many permutations from n objects taken r at a time. We write either npr or pnr. It is equal to n factorial by n minus r factorial. Now, can I ask one question? There are 25 articles. 25 articles. Any article you can imagine. You can imagine 25 books, different books. Taking 10 books, how many different ways you can arrange these books? Everyone, write in terms of factorial. Yes. Yes. It is correct answer, everyone. Gauri Nandan, yes. Rishikesh, what is the answer? Everyone wrote correct answer. It is 25 factorial divided by 25 minus 10. So it will be 15 factorial. Okay, so this is permutation. Now I am not going to teach you what is permutation, that you will learn more in your class, in your 11th standard or in 12th standard, you will learn more about it. Okay, now this one, look at this one. Here I'm going to make another type of arrangements. Another type of arrangements. You can read this question. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. There are eight digits. But 1, 4, 5, 8, I already fixed. I fixed already. And we have to make without repetition. We have to make without repetition. How many different numbers can we form? Yes, I can see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yes. Okay. Everyone wrote the correct answer. It is 4 factorial. Here, there are 2 vacant places. Here also 2 vacant places. So that means 4 vacant places are there. And we can use the number 2, 3, 6 and 7. Repetition not allowed. So it is 4 factorial, which is equal to 24. Correct answer. Now, look at the next question. Condition. Different condition is given. A different condition is given. Read carefully and write the answer. One, four, five, eight, again, fixed the number digits. You can use 2, 3, 6, 7 only. But you can use only the digit smaller than 4 before the digit 4 and smaller than 8 before the digit 8. So I can see here the answer is given yes. Yes, Rishikesh, correct answer. That is the exact way of representation. 2 factorial into 2 factorial. Okay, everyone got a correct answer, 4. Here we can place only 2 and 3 because we can use only the digits less than 4. So we can use 2 and 3, 2 and 3, 2 digits we can use in 2 factorial ways. Then here we can use, can I use here 2, 3, 5, 6? before 8, can I use 2, 3, 5, 6? That is my question. No. Why, Elena? Elena, you unmute your mic and say, why I can't use 2, 3, 5, 8?
Ma'am, it's specified over there. It should be smaller than 8 or before 8.
But it is smaller than 8. 2, 3 is smaller than 8, no?
Yes, ma'am, but we can't repeat and already we are using.
That is the correct answer. Without repetition. Yes. Without repetition. So I already used 2 and 3 here. So I can't take 2 and 3. Now I can take only 5 and 6. So here also it is 2 factorial. Why did I multiply? You all multiplied 2 factorial into 2 factorial. Is it 2 factorial into 2 factorial or 2 factorial plus 2 factorial?
Ma'am, when you're dealing with 2, 2 into 2 and 2 plus 2 is the same, but generally...
No. So if it is 3 and 3?
Ma'am, then you have to multiply.
Then why? That is my question. Why is it multiplication?
A tree diagram. So for the first possibility in the factorial, there are 3 factorial possibilities and like the tree diagram you can do it.
Correct. Very good. As I mentioned in the tree diagram, each option is going along with the other two options. That means you remember that tree diagram. How many of you remember the tree diagram? Here, two factorial arrangements are simultaneously going with these two factorial arrangements. It is AND, two factorial and two factorial. So it is 2 factorial into 2 factorial, hence the answer is 4. Okay. Do you have any doubts? If you have any doubt, you can ask. Now we are, otherwise I will show the next slide. It's clear? Rishikesh, Anvesha. Yes, Inub, Deviga, everyone. Okay, no doubts. Okay, now the next one. What is this? Anyone? Can you see anything here on the screen? Yes, what is that? Map of world. Okay. Have you heard about the word Pangaea? Have you heard about? Yes, what is that, Anvesha? Anyone?
Ma'am, before the earth was separated into continents, it was one huge landmass together, and that landmass was called Pangaea.
Yes. Yes. Supercontinent. Okay. Is there any other one like all the oceans? Some other name is there. Anyone knows that name?
Panthalassa.
Yes. All the oceans together. Supercontinent. All the continents together. So there are how many continents are there? How many continents?
Seven
continents. And how many oceans? 5 oceans. So there are 7 continents and 5 oceans. If I'm going to make it like this map straight, not like a globe. Okay. Make it straight and the question is, how many arrangements I can make? 7 continents and 5 oceans. There are 7 different continents and there are 5 different oceans. Anvesha, there are 7 continents. How many arrangements? Arrangements. Yes, yes, Alina, Abel, it is 7, you are multiplying, okay, it is 12 factorial, correct answer, if you arrange in any way, okay, it will be total 7 plus 5, total it is 12, 12 objects you are arranging, there is no other conditions, nothing is given, but now I will ask one question. Repetition allowed or not allowed in this case?
Ma'am, repetition not is not allowed.
Not allowed. Why? Why?
Because
we can't have two
countries.
Yes.
Not
we can't take two times a continent. Correct. Okay. Now, next question. If I arrange these continents and oceans, no two oceans come together.
Oh, ma'am, I already answered that.
No two oceans come together. Did you understand, children? There are seven continents and there are five oceans, but no ocean come together. Then how many different ways you can arrange? No need to multiply, just write in terms of factorial notation or permutation formula. No need to multiply. Josh, Devika, Anvesha, so much silence.
Okay, ma'am, can I say it then?
Okay, who is that? Abel, wait. Yeah. Rishikesh, there are seven continents and five oceans. How many ways you can arrange them, but no two ocean come together? We are arranging in straight. Okay. Anvesha wrote 12 factorial by 7 factorial. 12 by 5 factorial. Okay. Anvesha, can you explain?
Ma'am, when we use the formula.
Yes.
N factorial by n minus x factorial, so 12 factorial divided by 12 minus 5 factorial, because there are 5 oceans, so I that way.
But here you have to use all the 7 oceans and 7 continents and 5 oceans. You are not going to take only 5 articles, you are going to take everything. But you can't take together, like two oceans won't come together. In between two oceans, there should be one continent. Okay, Abel, now you can explain.
Okay, so the way I looked at it was, so first, the 7 continents, you can make 7 factorial permutations with them.
Okay.
And then you have the 5 oceans left. So the first ocean, you have 8 places to put it.
Okay.
For the second ocean, you'll have 7, 6, 5, 4.
Now,
so 7 factorial into 8, 7, 6,
5. Yes, you are correct. Your answer is correct. Now, all of you listen here. You are placing all the 7 oceans here, continents here, 5, 6, 7. Okay. You can place an ocean here. In between, you can place ocean. So how many places are available here? How many places? Any of these star, here I marked star, any of these place, you can fix an ocean. So how many places are there? You can see all these stars. Here one continent, second continent, okay. All the 7 continents you can arrange in 7 factorial ways. 8 places, correct. All these stars, these are the places available for the oceans. So there are 8 places, correct answer. And how many oceans we have? We have only 5 oceans. So from 8 available places, we have to arrange 5 oceans. How many different arrangements? Think about the permutation. Okay. 8 places and you are arranging 5 oceans. How many different ways you can arrange? Only oceans. Nikita?
Ma'am, ma'am, 8 factorial by 8 minus 5 factorial.
Yeah, that is correct answer, 8 to P5. So, 7 factorial ways you can arrange the continents multiplied by the oceans 8 to P5. The ocean 8 P5. Abel, your answer is correct. Your answer is correct. Okay, Abel. So, this is the calculation we do here. Now, others, any doubt? If you have doubt, you can see this question. How many ways can 5 girls and 3 boys be seated in a row? 5 girls and 3 boys be seated in a row? 8 factorial. That is a very easy question. 8 factorial. But look at the next question. If boys and girls sit separately, if boys and girls sit separately, how many? How many ways it is possible? Boys in one place, girls in one place. So how many different ways you can arrange them? 5 girls, 3 boys. Yes. Anoop. Not Anoop. Inoop. Devika. Inish. Rishikesh. Five girls separately, how many ways? Think about like 5 girls, how many ways we can arrange? 3 boys, how many ways we can arrange? And joined. Each boy's arrangement will go with a girl's arrangement. So how many different ways? No answer. 5 boys and 3 girls. How many ways you can arrange only 5 boys? Just write the answer. How many different ways you can arrange only 5 boys? Okay. Only 3 girls. Only 3 girls. 3. Yes. Then how many ways we can arrange them together? Together. Yes. Okay. But there is a problem there. You can arrange 5 boys in 5 factorial ways, that is correct. Girls in 3 factorial ways, that is also correct. But boys and girls, you can interchange, no? You can interchange boys and girls. First, you in a place, in a first bunch number 1, 5 boys are sitting. Arrange them 5 factorial ways. Bunch number 2, 3 girls are, 3 boys are sitting. Arrange them 3 factorial ways. So 5 factorial into 3 factorial ways. Now you can change the boys and girls, the bunches you can change. Okay. So it will be 5 factorial into 3 factorial into 2. Is it clear? Did you understand, Alina? Devika, okay, Anvesha, Abel already wrote answer, so no need to ask him. Yes, yes, okay. Now look at the next question. The same 5 girls and 3 boys be seated in a row so that no 2 boys are together. Like no 2 ocean come together. No 2 boys are together. Think if you get answer or if you don't get answer, nothing to worry because we are thinking, our brain is developing. Okay. So how many different ways we can do here? 5 girls, 3 boys seated in a row. So that no 2 boys sit together. Just to draw in your notebook. First girls position. then which all places are available for yes, Nikita, I think you wrote. Yes, Alina. Yes. This is 5 different places for the girls. And you can see here the vacant places for the boys. So there are 6 positions vacant for the boys, but there are only 3 boys. Okay, there are only 3 boys. So the answer will be 5 factorial into 6 by 3. Okay, these questions are little complicated, but don't worry. This is just to think in a different way. Okay, now read the next question. There are 5 girls and 5 boys. No 2 boys are together. So what is the answer? 5 girls, you can draw in the same way, 5 girls, fixed position, and it is 5 factorial ways. There are 6 vacant place. 6 vacant place. But there are only 5 boys. So what will be the answer? Nikita, can you tell me the answer?
Will it be 5 factorial into 6 minus 5 factorial?
It is 6P5, no, Nikita? 6P5, correct?
Yes, ma'am.
6P5. Okay. The previous one also, I think you are thinking in the correct way, but when you are writing that, you are making mistake. That doesn't matter. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
It is 6P5.